JWST is a reflective telescope. It works in the infrared. It's designed to detect the first stars and first galaxies that's ever formed in this universe.
So right after the Big Bang, seeing how the first light was actually created.
And so it works in what's known as infrared light.
Infrared light is actually a wavelength of light that's just beyond what we can actually see. So if we could tone our eyes into seeing how hot or how cold somebody was, that would be what infrared light is really tracing, is that thermal radiation.
Our atmosphere actually prevents infrared light from reaching the surface, so a ground-based telescope will not be able to detect these signatures. So we need to launch this into space away from the atmosphere. And to work in the infrared, it needs to be cold. Otherwise, the optics and the instruments are warm, and what it'll measure is instead itself, rather than these light signatures from the very early universe. In order to keep it cold, that's why we have a 5-layer sun shield to reflect sunlight and prevents it from heating up the instruments and the mirrors.
We want to know how galaxies actually started to form and evolve. Did they start from a couple of stars, or was it a giant energy burst? What actually was that process and how they were formed? We want to know how planets and stars are actually being born in their own dusty areas in space. That's something that we can't see with other wavelengths, so having the longer wavelengths in the infrared really shows us how some of these planets and stars are actually being born. In the solar system, we want to know what the atmosphere of Mars is doing from a more global perspective. While we have rovers and orbiters going around it, they only get that sort of, you know, airplane or local car sort of perspective. When we look at it with a telescope that's a bit further away, we can see the whole global climate of another planetary body. Jupiter and Saturn, the moons around these planets, we want to know what's going on with them.
But the Webb telescope is so powerful that it can do other things. It will track the evolution of galaxies through the entire age of the universe, essentially. And something else that's very exciting, which is if you point JWST at nearby stars, there is a good chance that if these stars harbor planets, that Webb will be able to detect those. And if nature cooperates, and we're very lucky, there are opportunities potentially that we can detect atmospheres
and see if any of them are like Earth. You know, if they have water, if they have a nitrogen atmosphere, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, the things that we find in our own atmosphere.
Once you can detect atmospheres, a whole new field of interesting things can open up.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.